थैंक यू डॉक्टर गायकवाड़। गुड मॉर्निंग ऑल ऑफ यू। मायसेल्फ डॉक्टर वैशाली चौधरी, एसोसिएट प्रोफेसर इन डिपार्टमेंट ऑफ पंचकर्मा। आई वेलकम टूडेज एमिनेंट स्पीकर आयुर्मित्र नाडीभिषक ज्योतिष वैद्य डॉक्टर के शिवरामा प्रसाद। ही इज अ प्रोफेसर एंड एचओडी ऑफ पंचकर्मा एल एन आयुर्वेद कॉलेज एंड हॉस्पिटल एल एन सिटी यूनिवर्सिटी कैंपस भोपाल मध्य प्रदेश। ही इज अ फाउंडर ऑफ द टेक्नो आयुर्वेदा, प्रोपोगेटर एंड पब्लिशर ऑफ द टेक्नो आयुर्वेदा मॉड्यूल्स पंचकर्म तंतु नाडी तौरम आयुर ज्योतिष एंड अलाइड साइंसेस। ही इज अ एडवाइजर ऑफ एसोसिएशन ऑफ आयुर्वेदिक प्रोफेशनल ऑफ नॉर्थ अमेरिका। ही इज अ चीफ फैकल्टी ऑफ कैनेडियन कॉलेज ऑफ आयुर्वेदा एंड योगा कैनेडा। ही इज ऑल्सो द मेंबर ऑफ बोर्ड ऑफ गवर्नर्स डिजिटल यूनिवर्सिटी ऑफ द स्किल रिसर्जेंस अ वर्चुअल मेटा यूनिवर्सिटी। ही इज अ एडवाइजर ऑफ महर्षि काश्यप आयुर्वेद रिसर्च फाउंडेशन केरला। ही इज एग्जीक्यूटिव एडिटर of International Journal of Research in Ayurveda and Medical Sciences. He is in editorial team of International Journal of Ayurvedic Medicine. He is a life member of NEMA, ex-BOS member of Calicut University. He is a author of many books, Techno Ayurveda, Ayur Jyotisham, Art of Panchakarma, Techno Ayurveda, SOP, Practical Panchakarma, Introduction to Evidence-Based Panchakarma, and so on. So I request Dr. K. Prasad sir, start your session. Sir, please proceed. Thank you.
Thank you very much.
Welcome, sir.
I am very much happy to be with you all and
yes,
today to deliver my lecture. I am very much thankful for the Ola sir, Mamta madam, and also for Vaishali madam and all the Panchakarma department people, those who are very specifically involved in this very big activity. To be frank, everybody speaks the much with that of the Ayurveda and Panchakarma. But combining the Ayurveda and Panchakarma with reference to the astrology is said to be the one of the most important thing which I am finding here. I am working on this particular astro medicine or the Ayur Jyotisham for the past 35 years. I have did even my PhD in the medical astrology very specifically. A part of that which is being made out and said as such are brought here as a part of the lecture. Now I would like to load my PPT here, and the PPT will start soon. Hope it is visible to you.
Yes, sir. It's visible, sir.
Thank you. Now, this Panchakarma, Ayurveda, and Ayur Jyotisham, when we are going to see, this is a very important aspect of the present day even. How to and why to, we have to use this particular module attached in Ayurveda is a big question. We are having a number of the questions with related to that of the what is this Ayur Jyotisham and why it is to be brought into the Ayurveda, where it is from started and where it is available, who has propagated it, when it is to be applied, and why it is to be learned, and how it is to be learned. Some of the questions and answers along with the relationship between the Panchakarma, Ayurveda, and also to that of the day and night and grahas are being brought out here in this particular PPT. Now, as this, what is this Ayurjyotisham? This Ayurjyotisham is a newly emerging branch of the Vedic Jyotisham, which is a blend of the Ayurveda and astrology. Previously, in the books of the astrology, Brihat Jataka, and many of the books has been referred by the Vice Principal Sir, which were seem to be having a number of the individual items which are related to that of the life is brought in the one compendium or book. Now this Vedic astrology, with reference to that of the medical astrology, Ayurjyotisham is necessity to be get expanded here. The Ayurveda is the science of the life that we know. And the Jyotisha is the light of the life. Without light, there is no existence. Here, the sun as star, which we are going to see, the star sun is emitting the light. Because this emitting the light is reaching at a 7-minute distance, which is called as a Goldilocks zone. In the Goldilocks zone, as we are here on the earth, we, our life is surviving. If there is no sun, there will be no light. There is no light, there is no life. So the life itself is getting started with the initiation of this Jyotisha. Jyotisha word itself is the derivation of the Jyoti Isha. Jyoti is the light here. The study of the life, the Sukham and the Dukham, both the things when we are going to see, when the disease itself is the psychological phenomena, the remedial measures which we are bringing out through that of the astrology are the remedial measures or the treatment modules which we are focusing and developing in Ayurveda, both the things are interrelated. When we are going to bring this, what to be done for a particular person, when there is an issue or a problem, a health issue in specific, what sort of the remedial daiva vyapasara chikitsa to be used has been nominated in Ayurveda are to be focused and practiced in the Ayurjyotisham. It is based totally on the natal horoscope or the casted horoscope. Sometimes what happens, some of the people may not be having the proper birth time. For them, we are going to have the horary or the prashna lagram. A person who is having a proper, normal, casted horoscope, we are going to follow the same thing. Where to see for this effect and narration, or otherwise, how we have to understand, this is in the cosmos. Where in the cosmos? See, in the cosmos, when we see on the clear sky, we are going to see n number of the stars. In our Milky Way galaxy in which we are staying, there are the trillions of the stars like the our sun. The sun is one star. For your kind information, when the stars are going to be get born, they never born as a single. Most of the time, they born as a two. These two stars, when we see, the two stars of the sun is having one, and the second star are the Juduva, or otherwise the twin star of our sun is called Nemesis. This Nemesis revolves around the sun, and thereby the sun is going to be get hit by the difference to the water which is available on the earth. The water which is available on the earth as on today was billions of the years ago, which was brought by the Nemesis, a twin star of the sun. This is a pretty thing which we are going to. So many mysteries are available in the cosmos. Commonly, here I have encircled some of the things. In this, there are constellations. Like the here in the chart, which I am showing is the Leo is there, Cancer is there, Virgo is there, Libra is there, along with the planets like the Mercury and Mars and also the Venus. So as these planets, when we are going to have a combination of the cumulative star effect, which is at a far away, many hundreds and thousands and millions of the light years away, they are giving the light to us and they are giving happiness to us. They are bringing so many astrophysical properties embedded. These astrophysical embedded properties are being showing and exposing to our individual life and giving rise either the comfort or the discomfort. When such things are happening, many people are going to say this astrology is a pseudoscience. It is not at all a pseudoscience. The astronomy is totally based on the knowledge of the calculative part or the Siddhanta Vibhaga of the astrology, which is going to give rise, what is the angulation position which is available or calculated from the point of the earth, which is called a geocentric. If it is being calculated far away the stars, we are going to calculate sun as a center and we are going to call it as a heliocentric. Now we know the result part of the astrology, which we call as on today, is to be derived from the astronomy, from the cosmos. When we see this cosmos energy, there are some of the Vedic verses in the Vedic sciences which we are not able to understand today. See, in the Mantra Pushpam, there are n number of the stanzas of the sloka. Agnirva apam ayatanam ayatanavan bhavati yo ayatanavan veda ayatanavan bhavati apova agnirva ayatanam ayatanavan bhavati yayevam veda yopam ayatanam veda ayatanavan bhavati. This is one small stanza which says the fire is the source of the water. He who knows this becomes established for himself. Water is the source of the fire. And who knows this becomes established in himself. He who knows the source of the water becomes the established himself. Just now I told you the water source is from the asteroids. And there is another stanza which we are going to see the relation with that of the planets like moon. Planet means here, the sun is a star, moon is a satellite, upagraha. Even then, we are going to say these two are to be considered as they are giving enormous effect over the individual. We call these two also as the planets in the, or grahas in the astrology. Chandramava apam ayatanam ayatanavan bhavati yas chandramasa ayatanam veda ayatanavan bhavati apo vai chandramasa ayatanam veda ayatanavan bhavati yayevam veda yopam ayatanam veda ayatanavan bhavati. This is the second stanza. Here the relation between the moon and the water source. Moon is the source of the water is being said. When the water is the source of the moon, he who knows this particular activity of this is going to be. See, the relationship between the first one, we are going to have this, the first and foremost. Will you please mute the all the people, not to get disturbed? When we know the relationship between the moon and the water, and this moon and water relationship is, one is from the asteroid which has been brought here from the nakshatrani, and second is said to be here the moon which is going to make the tides in the oceans, or it is going to raise the blood pressure of the individual, and it is going to show the psychological interferences for the life and our people, those who are living. When we see the another stanza here in this regard, we are going to see nakshatrani va apam ayatanam ayatanavan bhavati yo nakshatranam ayatanam veda ayatanavan bhavati apo vai nakshatranam ayatanam ayatanavan bhavati yayevam veda yopam ayatanam veda ayatanavan bhavati. Stars are the source of the water, and the water is with the stars. When we have this water and the source He who knows this source of the water, ultimately he is established himself, is being stated. Now here, the question of the three varieties of the planets are being included in the astrology, Jyotisham. The first one is the Mandala Grahas, which are moving always the forward, Chandra and Surya. From the geocentric angular calculation, these two objects of the celestial objects, always they are going to move forward. There is no angulation, reflection towards the back is being said. When we see the other planets, as they are all moving, we are all moving in an elliptical way. These other planets, Buddha, Kuja, Guru, Shukra, and Shani, these five planets are going to be reflective in the sunlight. They are look like the stars. You can just see, as I have shown in the example, there the stars are objects are being visualized with the naked eye like a sparkling stars because of the reflection of the sun. These stars are making an angulation in the elliptical way as if it is going back, this Vakrata retrogradation. This retrogradation is said to be the problematic, and it gives the bad effects for a horoscope or bad effects for an individual who is bearing that horoscope. Who propagated this particular science is question. Ayurjyotisham is the medical part of the forecasting through the natal horoscope, which is being embedded, included in different chapters of the Jyotisha Granthas. These Jyotisha Granthas, when we are trying to deal as a separate health and disease conditions based upon the Grahas position in the zodiac signs Rasi, Mesha, Vrushabha, Midra, Karkada, till Meena, 12 Rasis, these effects are going to be evaluated. When the science has been brought out, many a times it is a big question comes at all. The Ramayana and Mahabharata, which we are speaking, they are not of the present day. It is a billions of the years ago has been happened. 30,000 years is the Kali Yuga span. Two times is the Dwapara Yuga, three times is the Krita Yuga, and four times is the Treta Yuga. That means we are going to say many n number of the years are going to be 4.3 million years is the total one Mahayuga. In this Mahayuga, especially this Rama, who is there, Ramayana is said to be in the 24th Mahayuga happened. At present, we are in the 28th Mahayuga. Four Mahayugas has been passed already. And the Dwapara Yuga, of the 28th Mahayuga, the Mahabharata war happened, which is approximately 5,200 years ago. The 5,200 years ago, the Kali Yuga has been started. This nomenclature is well and understood, and when these characters were brought, also were understood through the Jyotisha Granthas. In the latest period, after the propagation of the Surya, Parashara, Jaimini, and many more of the ancient sages billions of years ago, recently Raja Veerasimha has written a Veerasimhavalokanam, a book available for us. And after that, this is going to belongs to 1383 AD. And the Basavaraja, who has written a book in the Telugu in the 17th, 18th century in between. And these two books very specifically deal the medical astrology. When we see this medical astrology being dealt, why to learn this Ayurjyotisham becomes a question for us. If we see our Ayurveda Granthas, in the Charaka Samhita, it is being told, Shadanga Angamanga Vijnanam. Shadanga Vijnanam means it is a Siksha, Kalpa, Vyakarana, Chanda, Nirukta, and Jyotisha. Jyotisha is one of the most important subject to be learnt by the physician is being told in Ayurveda. Jyotisham as a Shadanga, which refers with that of the cosmic knowledge, which is going to be get imparted in the Ayurveda text through that of the words which are come across Nakshatra, Tithi, and many more in. Especially in the Janapatodhams Adhyaya, we are going to see these references much and more. The utility of this cosmic power, when we are going to see to improve the health condition through the Daiva Vyapasraya Chikitsa, as we have the Sattva Vajaya Chikitsa, Daiva Vyapasraya Chikitsa, and the other things. Daiva Vyapasraya Chikitsa here, the Mani Mangala Dharana, Aushadha Dharana are going to be the one of the factors to be imposed on a diseased patient is to be understood. For that, we need to learn this Ayur Jyotisham. This Ayur Jyotisham, the School of Techno Ayurveda brought out a research-oriented certificate of proficiency in Ayur Jyotisham course for the 30 hours, and many universities even offering the diplomas and degrees of the medical astrologists. Usually, the entire syllabus is going to be of the Vedanga Jyotisha learning along with that of the Rasi, Graha, Nakshatra, Drikkana, and Kala Purusha Anga Prachanga Vipaga. Such important things are going to be brought here. When we see these things are going to be used, the relationship with that of the Ayurveda and the Jyotisha has to be get established. Ayurveda states the Vaya Horatra Bhuktanante Majjadiga Kramat. The Vaya Ahoratra. Ahoratra is the total day and Bhukta relations. Here, this hour, Hora, the word has been developed in astrology with reference to that of the Ahoratra, where the Akara of the first one, Rakara of the last one, Trakara of the last one is being omitted. The in between the Hora is being taken. The Hora is otherwise as hour. Hourly references, hourly living style predictions are going to be told here. Or hourly how the individual lives also being told here. The weekdays, when we see the Sunday, Monday, Somavara, Budhavara, Mangalavara, how they have derived is, they have derived because the n number of the Hora, the sun, moon, all these seven planets are rotatory hourly for their effectiveness on an individual. In a particular day, if it is going to be started with the Surya Hora, that is the Sunday. Sunday is the Adhyavara. It is supposed to be the first day of the working, whereas Senivara, the Mandavara, is supposed to be holiday. Very unfortunately, because of the British ruling, we got the Sunday as a holiday and Saturday as a working day, which is not at all comfortable to work even. Even in the previous schooling days, usually the Amavasya is said to be the always an inauspicious day, and Chaturdasi before Amavasya, Amavasya, that is a new moon day, and the immediately the Padya of the Amavasya, these 3 days, there were no education. The institutions were given holidays for 3 days. When we see this, as such, the schooling and curriculums and Ayurveda together, these things are going to speak about learning about much more the celestial objects, and also even with reference to that of the health condition based upon the doshas. All these planets having the attributions of the body tissues, panchamahabhutas, rasas, and etc. In the astrology, we predominantly use the and derive the health conditions and disease state to be marking with the reversibility activities and the reversible management, thereby the using either of the aushadhis or the gems or the metals. Usually the ratna, loha, and vruksha are being used here. When we see this, how they are being distributed in the Ayur Jyotisham, the concept of the Kala Purusha Anga Prachanga Vibhaga, I said. Here the Kala Purusha Anga Prachanga Vibhaga have the different classifications. One is the Sthira, the fixed one. Second is the Chara or the float. The Chara is going to be based on the Bhava, which is starting from the Lagna. Lagna is the rising of the horizon for an individual at his birth time. When we see this Lagna, as which understanding is to be followed for the Chara body parts concept, and sthira or fixed body concepts is commonly being followed by all the people. Here in this table I have given, like Mesha is the head, Rishabha is the face, and Mithuna is for the chest, Karkata is for the heart, Simha is for the abdomen, Kanya is for the groin, Tula is for the umbilicus, Vrishchika is for the genitalia, Dhanu is for thigh, Makara for the knee, and Kumbha for the calf and ankles, Meena for that of the feet. This is one classification. A recent research-oriented approach has been made in the KP astrology, KP system of the astrology, and also from the school of the techno Ayurveda. There is a detailation of the classification organ relationships established scientifically and on the basis of the research about this Kala Purusha Anga Pratyanga Vibhaga. Whenever a disease is going to be precipitated in a body, we have to follow this concept of the body parts, and thereby we have to evaluate which body part is linked with. Apart from that, even the school of Techno Ayurveda is even working on the pulse diagnosis. Tantu also is there. We have to mix different kinds of the informations and technologies in the Ayurveda imparted. Thereby the Ayurveda is full-fledged and full-proof mechanism to follow astrology. When we observe from the Charaka's typology of the classifications from the Aushadha Sevana Kala,
sir, hello.
Yes, somebody muted me, I believe so. Okay, here when we are going to see the Charaka's typology, this Charaka typology is going to be stated with the reference to that of the dispensing of the either the medicine or the Panchakarma procedures. When we see this dispensing of the Panchakarma procedures as Dinakala, Aturakala, Aushadakala, Vyadhikala, Jirnakala, and Rutukala are being stated. When these timings are going to be observed here, we have a detailed explanation of this typology here. For example, the Dinakala. When we say, as the Brahmi Muhurta, we start with the 4 o'clock and the Nishi is the 8 p.m. till that time, the dispensing of the medicines and also the Panchakarma are being indicated. Now, when we are seeing the Horas, the Hora, there is a, in the Panchanga, you are going to see the Dina Horas. A disease which is related to that of the Hora, with reference to that of the Ayurveda said timings are to be appropriately, interpretatively adopted and observed here. Say here, if suppose Akshatarpana is going to be done in the 4 p.m. If in the Akshatarpana is going to be done, so Chandrama Manasaudyataha Suryojate Suryochakshu Ajayate, Surya is referred with the ophthalmic area. Then the vision visual problems are when the Akshatarpana is being made. If it is done in the Surya Hora, the medicine is going to be very effectively acting and it is going to be effectively showing. The Abhyanga, we are using the Tailam. When we are using the Abhyanga, the Taila, if the Shani is responsible for the Kandara, the Abhyanga is very specifically for the Kandara and Asthi and the joints. If the Sharihora is preferred for the Abhyanga, then the Abhyanga is going to be double resultant. In the same way, here from the 6 o'clock to 11 o'clock, based upon the Hora, we can go with the different studies of this, different procedures of the Panchakarma, and especially after the Anuvasana, 1 p.m., the Anuvasana Vasti. Even the Anuvasana Vasti as a Kevala Taila Vasti, this is preferred in the Shani Hora very specifically. And the Niruha Vasti, as it is having the water and the things, then the water are as a fluid, the Chandra Hora also can be undertaken. Or otherwise, we can choose the n number of the planets which are responsible for the dosha, which I am going to discuss in the later part. They are going to be get observed in the timings when we are looking in specific. The next comes as the Athura Kala. Here the Athura Kala selection, which is going to be Balavan. The strength, Adana Kala, Visarga Kala, two things which we are having. Here this Surya Hora, Chandra Hora. When the Lagna is going to be made out, when a particular Rasi of the first 15 degrees and second 15 degrees are going to be said with reference to that of the Chandra Hora and Ravi Hora based upon the divisional chart or the Shodasya Vargas in astrology. When we are seeing the strength is related with that of the Ravi Hora, Chandra Hora is going to be Kapha Prabhava. And Pitta Adhikata is going to be seen with the Ravi Hora. A Pitta Adhika Vyadhi, Pitta Anubandha Vyadhi are to be treated in a particular Rasi Lagnas, the first 15 degrees with the respective that of the Ravi Hora and the second as a Chandra Hora, as it is going to be different with the Rasis are to be observed. Whenever such Lagna is going to be there or the Rasi is going on the horizon, we have to follow Chandra Hora to be followed for the Kafanubandha Vyadhis and Ravi Hora has to be followed for the Pittanubandha Vyadhis. The third one is commonly which we are going to see as the Aushadha Sevana Kala, the typology 10 are said in relation with that of the food very specifically. Bhukta. Whenever we are looking in the astrology, Agni is related with that of the Mesha Rasi and Kujagraha. The Kujagraha is Agni and Atma Shakti is the Ravi. When this Agni is the digestive power is linked with that of the Kuja and the Rasa is linked with that of the Buddha. Rasa Pradushaja Vyadhis are the Buddha Graha influenced are to be understood. Thereby, the Pradushaja Vyadhis are to be understood here according to the planet. Thereby, Bhukta relations are to be observed here. When we see the other way, the Aushadha Sevana Kalas referred with that of the Panchavidha Vatas are going to be seen. School of Techno Ayurveda brought a different classification relation based upon the different Rasis in relation with also. These are distributed with that of the Pranavata, Udanavata, Bhukta relation and also Rasi relation. When we follow this relationship of the Ayurjyotisham, at that time we are going to be perfectly managing the patient is observed. Many a times it is a question, even though we are giving text said very right medicine, the patients are not responding properly. That is because of the same. As such, we are having a problem with the dispensing medicine according to the timing of the event with relation to that of the celestial bodies of the grahas and nakshatras and rasis. Thereby, we are facing the difficulty in treating the public or the people are going to be understood here. Of course, the timeline of the Shankara, when we are going to see, here the each and everything is related with that of the, once again with the Panchavidha Vatas and a specific procedure which is to be done here. As the relationships of the different Grahas and Mahabhutas are to be studied with relation to that of the astro medicine or the Ayurjyotisham. When we see the different rasas, Madhura, Amla, Lavana, Katatikta, Kashaya rasas are to be linked with that of the Grahas here. Guru Graha is linked with the Madhura rasa, Sukra for the Amla Rasa, Chandra for the Lavana Rasa, Ravi for the Katu Rasa, Kuja for the Tikta Rasa, and Shani for that of the Kashaya Rasa, and Buddha for the Mishraka Rasas. When we see this, might be you observe the Skandhas, Kashaya Skandha, Madhura Skandha, Amla Skandha, Dravyas. The Dravyas are very specifically related to that of the individual planets which are said to be giving rise a particular problem in the body. The doshas, when they are related, Madhura Rasa, Guru Graha, Kapha is the directly, and whereas the Kapha Pitta for the Surya, Sukra, and also for the Chandra. Sukra Chandras are the Kapha Pitta Dosha Vyadhis are going to be brought out, and whereas the Kapha Vyadhis are going to be brought out by that of the Guru. And Ravi gives the Vata Pitta Vyadhi, Dvandajya Vyadhi, Kuja gives the Kevala Vata Vyadhi, Shani gives the Kevala Vata Vyadhi, Buddha is going to give rise to the Doshaja Vyadhi. Already we come across as the Rasa Pradoshaja Vyadhi, Rakta Pradoshaja Vyadhi. How to make out this Rasa Pradoshaja, Rakta Pradoshaja Vyadhi in reference to that of Graha. Now the answer for that, which we are going to see here, is the Ravi is set for the Asti. All the Asti Pradushaja Vyadhis are under the influence of the Surya Graha. Chandra is blood-related diseases. And whereas the Kuja is the bone marrow diseases, Buddha is going to give the Rasa Pradushaja Vyadhis or the plasma disorders. Guru gives the Medho Pradushaja Vyadhis, fat-related diseases. Sukra gives the Sukra Artava, genetic material disorders in common. Shani gives the musculoskeletal problems, and Mamsa Pradoshaja Vyadhis are going to be seen here. When you see Vata Vyadhis very specifically, Ravi, Kuja and Shani, these three are going to be brought forward here. Now, you may be asking, we are having a different levels of the disorders and there was no mention of the Rahu and Ketu here. Kujavat Ketu, Shanivat Rahu. Ketu, whenever he is being malefic, a papagraha in a horoscope, he gives like Kuja. And the Shani like is going to be the Rahu. Rahu gives all the disorders of the Shani. Apart from this Rahu and Ketu very specifically linked with that of the genetic disorders. The genetic disorders like the autism or the tetralogy of the Fallot, whichever are going to be our congenital disorders, these are going to be developed under the influence of the Rahu and the Ketu. They are some of the physical, they are some of the psychological. If the psychological disorders are going to be there, at the time we are looking forward for the Ketu very specifically. Ketu is for the psychological along with the Chandra, and also he is going to give the afflictions, whereas the Rahu gives the physical afflictions. Like autism, is the Ketu affliction is more than that of the Rahu. These are to be utilized when a marriage alliance is being made. At the time of the making the marriage alliance, say for example, a couple has to be get married. At that time, if we see this fifth place of the from the Lagna for the male and female afflicted by the Rahu are going to have a genetical problems derivative child is being observed. N number of the example horoscopes have been collected by the School of Techno Ayurveda, and we are making a further research to establish it as a golden rule even. When we see these combinations of the nakshatras, varas and tidhis, for the death has been said in the Basavarajiya. As you see, a Ketu Nakshatra, like the Nakshatras are 27 in number, they are being distributed with the 9 Grahas, from the Ashwini, Bharani, Kritika, till to that of the Reva, the 27 Nakshatras. Out of these, the Ketu Nakshatras like Mula, Makha, Sukra Nakshatra like Bharani, Pubba, Purvashadha, Rahu Nakshatra like Ardra, Swati, Satabhisha, Guru Nakshatra like Vishakha and Purabhadra, Buddha Nakshatra Astesha, if it is going to fall on the Sunday Bhanuvara or Tuesday Mangalavara and Saturday Shanivara, the people are going to have the problem and they are going to be related with that of the death. The person is going to die if the disease is going to be developed in the particular day. The different has been said. If it is of the Patya, there is a comfort ananda. Chaviti, yes, Rikta Tidhi, it is going to kill certainly. And whereas Shashti Tidhi is Ananda Tidhi, there is a possibility of the reversal. That means he goes up to the deathbed and he don't die it. And whereas in the Navami as a Rikta Tidhi, the person is certainly to die, and also in the Chaviti. Dwadasi is for the Subha, the person is going to be get rectified and can come back. When we see the relationships with the reference to that of the Panchakarma according to Rutu, already we know Vasanta Vamana and Varsha Basti and Sharad Virechana. These are with reference to that of the Rutusanthi, very specifically we are trying to do. But a disease, this is for Rutusanthi, is for only for the healthy persons, but not for the diseased person. Diseased persons are going to be making themselves with any of this Rutu, very specifically Chaitra Vaisakha Masas, in total is comfortable for that of the Vamana Karma. Like the Shravana Bhadrapadas. Now at present the Shravana is going on. Shravana Bhadrapadas are for the best for the Basti Karma, and Asvija Kartikas for the Virechana has to be said. Here, when we see this reference to that of the Masa or the months, we can use this facility of this celestial bodies and we can make it out. When we are going to observe a particular Tithi, Tithi is, there are 15 Tithis, which are going to start from the Padya to that of the Amavasya or also Purnavi. The one Paksha is going to have the 15 Tithis. Out of these 15 Tithis, especially Nanda, Bhadra, Jaya, Purna Tithis are no problem. But these Tithis are going to give, especially like happiness and health and also victory. Say, for example, here, whenever a surgical procedure is to be undertaken, it is better to be observed with the Jayatithi, that is the Tadiya, Ashtami and Trayodashi. If a person is going to have a Panchakarma, Ananda and Bhadra, that is Nanda Bhadra Tithis are going to be good enough. The Purna Tithi, you can use it for either for the surgery or also procedurals. But always to be avoided is the Rikta Tithi, because this particular Rikta Tithi is going to be giving rise to the problem. This is going to give the loss of the body tissues and also it may lead to the death. This is whether if, suppose today is the Chaviti, shall I stop? The no practice is to be done? No, not like that. Whenever you are initiating a practice of the initiation, if suppose you are starting a procedure or you are starting the medication, don't start a medication on the Chaviti, Navami and Chaturdasi. These three diseases are to be avoided. When we are going to avoid, then the person is going to get recovered properly. Even when we are going to see in the Panchanga, there are different yogas. 27 yogas were told here. Out of the 27 yogas, they are going to be a combination and they are going to follow. You can follow the Panchanga. If it is of the Atiganda Yoga, Shula Yoga, Ganda Yoga, and Pariga Yoga, Vedradhi Yoga, these yogas, if they are going to be there, please try to avoid initiation of a procedure or a medication on the particular day. Apart from this, we are going to see even the Tarabala and Chandrabala in the Panchakarma. The Tarabala, Chandrabala, there are the nine grahas. Nine grahas are linked with that of the 27 stars in the three rotations or three rounds. When this Janmatara is there, in which star the Chandra is there with, is to be observed here. The Janmatara, Sampatara, Vipattara, Kshematara, Prachitara, Sadhanatara, Naidantara, Mitratara, the Parama Mitratara, out of this nine, when we are going to see, very specifically Naidanatara, when it is going to be there, you have to stop the procedure and you should not initiate it. If it is getting continued, it can be done with. All the programs are to be employed in the Janmatara, and Vipattara may give some obstacles, so be careful about it. And the complications may be developed in the Pratyaktara if you are going to be get started, and Naidantara to be avoided always, all the time. And the rest of the Janmatara, Sampattara, Kshematara, and Sadhanatara, Mitratara, Paramitratara are said to be the good enough for you to be used. Here, I just want to conclude myself with reference to, and Ayurjyotisham is a developing independent science based on the Ayurveda, astrology, and also research in prospective and retrospective methods. The science suggests the better times for the Panchakarma. Other treatments that we are applying suitable for the patient. Ayurjyotish is going to offer the better opportunities to deal unknown conditions in the field of the Ayurveda. Many unknown conditions physically that are not possible to be visualized can be observed through the astrology. The Ayurjyotisham, or the casting horoscope for the medical astrology, is said to be a scanning method of the individual for total lifetime is being understood here. When we see this sort of the achievements through the Ayurjyotisham, one has to get a fond of this Ayurjyotisham. I am very much thankful for the Evla sir, Mamta madam, and Vishali madam, and all the Panchakarma department of the DPU and DY Patil University. And I am very much thankful for the one and all those who have listened very quiet, calm, without making any noise, and no disturbance is being made for the lecture. For all of them, I am very much thankful. And as the people, those participants who have made the decorum of this online webinar, I am very much thankful for them. And I am thankful for the, once again, DY Patil management, DY Patil patrons, and also DY Patil employees, and especially the Panchakarma department. Thank you very much.